Commander?
Oh, he's not too bad. A couple of fractured ribs, broken ankle. Dr. Russell says he'll be out for a few days, but he'll be okay. Nothing serious. Witters, you think you can fill that chair for a while?
Yes, sir.
Separate the men from the boys.
I won't let you down, sir.
All right. Any problems, check with Carter. I'll be in my quarters.
Good night, Commander.
Good night.
Morning, Commander. Tell me you've seen something like that before.
Nope. Nor has computer.
Main mission calling Commander Koenig.
Main mission calling Commander Koenig.
Witters, this better be more than urgent.
I think it is, sir.
Magnification.
By all that's scientific, if that's a spacecraft.
Defies every known law of aerospace propulsion.
Like the bumblebee, which shouldn't fly.
But does.
Yeah. Kano, let's see what computer has to say about it.
Computer, I want detailed information about the space object. Anything.
I have nothing to say on that subject.
Nothing, Commander. I can't explain it.
My information is privileged.
Good day, dear friends. I wouldn't intrude, but I rather need your immediate help.
We've lost visual, Commander.
He's not reaching us on radio waves. Computer's scrambled.
I'm trying all channels.
Not to worry. Our communication is excellent. In a moment, even with your restricted sight, you will see me.
Friendly?
Better ask louder.
Suppose you get the wrong answer.
Kano, ask computer if that thing is armed.
I am otherwise occupied.
Do grant permission to land on your territory, Commander.
For what reason?
I need your help. Isn't that reason enough?
Possibly.
We're peaceful.
I wonder what kind of people.
That thing's hostile.
And asks for help.
It's clever.
Show some compassion, Alan.
Survival first, brotherhood after.
Excuse me. I don't wish to hurry your democratic discussion. But I have an emergency.
And we have our emergency.
But mine is greater than your fear.
Yes. Permission to land.
I'm obliged.
Away from our base.
Of course. One should be careful with strangers.
Hold it.
I gave permission to land, not to approach.
Can't you see, Commander? My intentions are pacific.
With respect, no.
I only require your assistance.
Alan, send out two Eagles, fully armed. They'll fire only on my instructions.
I shouldn't do that if I were you.
Why?
Because I won't let you.
Alan, do as I say.
Commander, I'm not getting through.
Your intercommunication system will function when I want it to. Now, Commander, shall we be reasonable?
If you come in peace.
If? My word is my bond.
Then I'm prepared to receive a small delegation. Unarmed, of course.
No. I shall welcome a small but influential delegation, consisting of Dr. Helena Russell, Professor Victor Bergman, and yourself, Commander John Koenig. Of course.
Are we going?
Do we have a choice?
I'm delighted, Commander. Greetings, Alvarez. You will now be delivered to my control room.
No contact, nothing.
No visual.
No computer again.
I'm taking those eagles up.
You heard the threat?
Yep, and that's why I'm carrying out the commander's original orders.
Welcome aboard, Alpha Party. Just let yourselves go. It's quite safe to come out now. Do come in, that we may be well met.
Said the spider to the fly.
Children's stories are brutal, Professor. But you have nothing to fear.
Except fear itself.
Yes. The wise man knows when to be afraid. You are very kind, but I have yet to need assistance. I regret not welcoming you on your arrival. I rest only when I must. Now, How can I help you?
It's more a question of how we can help you. You summoned us.
Summoned?
For help.
I'm Dr. Helena Russell. This is Commander John Koenig, Professor Victor Bergman.
I am Companion.
Perhaps if you could send for the others, they could explain.
I know why you are here, Commander. You think I don't know what you're doing? Why you're silent, Gwent? Are you ashamed of your actions, Gwent? Then I'll speak for you. Devious. He leaves me to deal with his lesser matters.
Where is Gwent?
His purpose in coming here is clearly twofold. I'm well aware of the first and can surmise the second. So I shall speak only what I know.
Thank you, sir.
From time to time, we must interrupt our endless journey to obtain certain items necessary to our continued well-being. Now you take an interest. When you want something. I suppose he has issued a long list of his requirements.
Some list, Victor.
We have most of the basics.
I have consulted your computer. You have everything I need. As I said, devious. Why make me explain and then interfere? You were handling things so badly, I had to intervene. Badly? Then I withdraw. You can tell him whatever you want. You presume too much on our relationship, Companion. I'm glad to hear I can. Well now, Commander Koenig, can I count on your cooperation?
We'll do our best. If in fact we can spare all that.
I've already told you.
Thank you, but I'd like to hear it from our computer.
Oh, then do so. By all means, let us go through chance. You're wasting your time, you know. He controls your computer. It will say whatever he wants it to say. You may speak to your computer, you may speak to yourself. Ask your questions. Go on. Do you dispute my word of honor?
Faith, hope, and...
Gwent's orders have been relayed to supply department and await shipment on Dock 4.
Connell, can you hear me?
Yes, Commander.
When was this order given?
7:11 hours.
23 minutes ago, Commander.
You presume too much, Gwent.
You are a commander.
I demand to see you, Gwent.
You do! Everything is Gwent.
Gwent? This machinery?
Machine? Call me a machine?
Well, if you're not a machine, show yourself.
You control this machine.
He is not entirely self-sufficient. Almost.
But you do have ultimate control.
Over Gwent? No, no. Would that I could. some of the time.
Control me? Control me?
I really would. Do as he says.
But surely you must control this apparatus.
Oh, please. Please don't anger him. Please. Call him. Gwent.
Now, don't speak. I can help you.
Companion, if you're not dead, then speak.
All you care about.
He's extremely sick.
No, no. I'm fit. These little attacks come and go. Mere discomfort.
Are you certain, dear friend?
Not to worry about my capabilities. Send for your supplies so we can be on our way. Done quickly, if you please.
All right. I'll issue the order the moment we're back on Alpha.
No. From here.
This time you have my word.
I believe only in my honor. Issue that order.
Please. Accommodate him. He always has his way.
Always.
You will get your supplies when we are back on Alpha.
No, Commander, no. None of us here, not you, not I, can stand up to him.
Haven't you any influence?
Gwent is my master. I have always been his companion. I've grown old in his service. Companions die, but Gwent goes on. Forever. Nothing can stop him. Forget your insufferable pride. Give him what he wants and then go. While you still can.
Gwent, your companion is dying. I do not have the medical equipment here. If I could get him back to Alpha.
Enough. Do what I say.
No.
I can blast your base from the universe.
Winters, immediate launch. Attack to disable.
Ready and waiting, Commander.
We're on our way.
Measure for measure.
Attention.
What's wrong with him?
He's dying.
Companion must not die.
Words won't save him.
Don't pretend you didn't know I was dying. I said there were two reasons we came here. I am the second one.
You knew he was dying.
You don't understand. Tell him you didn't want to admit I was dying. That my death is part of your life. You won't even admit it now, will you?
No, you're not dying. You're only feigning, trying to annoy me. Admit it, you old fool.
Admit nothing.
sorry to leave behind the worst part of me.
Gwent?
Yeah, Gwent. It's me. But he outgrew me. Think of me at my best. I leave you to his dreadful mercy.
Companion. Companion. Companion.
Is dead.
Blind savages. You killed him. Now, you will prepare him for burial.
Look, it is lifting off.
Carter here.
Status.
Both Eagles have superficial damage, but they're operational. I have the machine in sight.
Pursue it and stand by to attack.
Companion is ready. I must needs speak in passion, but he hears me not. Here lies companion, my first friend, who served me without complaint or self-pity, the best of his kind. Gone now. I cherish his memory. His memory remains someone.
We commit to eternal space the body of companion.
Is that all?
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Is that?
Sensors indicate a body.
Alive?
Dead.
Execution of a hostage.
I'm moving in.
No. They'll all be killed. Eagles 1 and 2 return to base. Now.
Get that load of supplies on Dock 4 into an Eagle ready to lift off on my order.
It is coming back.
Destruction of Alpha imminent.
Is Eagle 4 loaded with those supplies?
Ready in 2 minutes, sir.
There is no one to restrain me now. Commander, give your men the order.
Winters, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
We're still alive.
All of you?
Yes. Get those supplies ready.
They are ready, sir.
What assurance do I have, Gwent, that you will release us once the supplies are delivered?
Assurance?
me.
Your famous word of honor?
If that will do.
It won't.
You know, Commander, your hostility tires me. Companion's love was a source of joy. Must I waste valuable energy punishing you?
Waste energy?
Gwent! What about those assurances?
No further discussion. When I return, those supplies will be on hand. If you care to distinguish between life and death.
Somewhere, everywhere, there's no sense in whispering. Gwent! Gwent! Gwent!
He needs to conserve energy. Obviously, he's low on vital supplies.
The lights.
Needs. He has needs.
And Gwent has never lived alone.
It's not just the supplies.
With Companion dead, he must have a replacement. Wait! Wait!
His heart.
What is your emergency?
Heart seizure.
Will you help us?
Which of you?
Are you blind?
Separate. He has an artificial heart. He's in a force field.
The heart's drained of power.
Move him. Hurry.
Must get him back to Alpha.
Stand back. 3,000 volts of electrical energy for 5 seconds. Done.
Victor. Are you all right?
Alive and well. And very much obliged.
Indeed you are. Like my companion. I miss him. We understood each other, despite petty differences. He was such marvelous company.
Ah. And you were actually friends.
Companion and I were fellow travelers. Forever. So we thought.
Ah, well. Everything changes.
I don't. Companion always relied on me.
And you always relied on Companion.
Commander. Order your men to deliver my supplies. Now!
Gwent? I've given you a lot of thought.
So you should.
You're not getting those supplies. It's you or us. Negotiating, Gwent.
I count the costs, Commander.
To both of us, Gwent.
Still counting, Commander.
We're willing to risk our lives to stop you.
So be it.
Quint, whatever you say.
Whatever words appeal to you.
Surrender is sufficient.
Cease fire. Recall all Eagles.
Cease fire.
So much better, dear friends. And I commend your courage, though it was, as you see, ill-advised. These are my terms. Professor Bergman, because of your age and defective condition, you'll return to your base in exchange for my supplies. Commander Koenig, Dr. Russell, you will stay with me as my companions for as long as you both shall live. Now, get those supplies.
Prepare to lift off supplies.
Yes, sir.
Professor Bergman, you'll be delighted to know your transport has arrived.
Gwent. Please. Let them go.
No. You weary me, Professor.
At least let Dr. Russell go.
And deprive you of your companion.
The supplies. Sir. Everything that was on the list. Where do you want them?
Just set them down where you're standing.
It's all accounted for.
I'll see for myself. Detect a weapon?
No. Now, this is a comm lock. It's part of our intercommunication system.
Indeed. Army, it's no use trusting humans. Always trying out your mindless schemes. Do you think me a fool? Get out of here with those weapons.
But the professor, well, you said we...
That was before your treachery. Now the professor stays with me. Get out!
You're not letting him go?
Tell your men to return to their craft before I do something you regret.
Alan!
Yes, Commander.
Fire at the door! Now!
What a pitiful attempt! You're only good for killing each other! Wait, give us... Gwent taketh away. Ah, well. Some small use can be made of your experience, Professor Berger. Get out! Before I kill you. Get out! You are defenseless against me. No more demonstrations. Now, my dear companions, get those supplies. Come along. Come along, come along. This one first. Hurry, please. Hurry. Open it. Open it. Over here. Here. Insert it. Here. Quickly.
Firing, Gwent. You didn't hurt us so much that time. Are you immortal, Gwent?
I have enough energy left to destroy you and your entire base. I warn you.
All right, then. Come on and get it over with.
I demand your cooperation.
Cooperation? Who the hell are you? We don't know who you are, where you've been, or where you're going.
I am Derma Paris Plebus Wendt of the planet Zemo. A man of considerable importance on that planet. Perhaps not fully recognized as a scientific genius I am. I created this entity, an extension of myself. My entire personality is here. And combined with it is the superior ability of the computer's brain and all the might and power known to our planet. I am impervious to destruction and powerful enough to destroy an entire universe. That is who I am. Delma Powers Grievous Wit.
Well, Delma, Powers Plebus Gwent, you have lost.
Don't! Please.
You can expend your last energies destroying us, if you wish. But in the end, you will die.
Misjudged you. My experience over these years, traveling the universe alone, blind, dependent on companion, has left me untrusting, suspicious, cynical, perhaps paranoid. You see, having built this... Yes, machine to preserve my personality. I discovered too late its inherent weakness. I need company. None of us exists except in relation to others. Alone, we cease to have personalities. Isolation. Do you understand?
Oh, my dear Quint. You were wrong from the beginning. To attempt to preserve one's personality is the ultimate vanity.
Yes. Yes, you're right. It was vanity. The first and last of all sins. I would like to thank you. I welcome my release.
The oxygen's going.
Quint! Open the door, let us out! Quint!
We've been too successful. He's killed himself. And us with him.
Commander Koenig.
Not the lights. Oxygen. Oxygen. Open the door.
You sure?
Yeah.
Goodbye, dear friends.
sure you're all right, sir. I'm fine.
He's alive.
He's coming straight towards us.
Quick, Sergeant, get him on visual.
He's not lifting up.